Hello there, my music lovers, I'm Josh from the file Heaven, and today we are going to have a look at the analog audio AA DAC. I'm having a little speaker stand help me with this review because I wanted to do it standing because I'm having a better energy while I stand and speak to you. The box tells you that the DAC is fragile and that the contents should be handled with care, but you should have the most care about your hearing because I want you to be able to enjoy music for years like I have been enjoying music with the analog audio AA DAC. The experience with this DAC has been outstanding. It is one of a kind, this DAC. The first thing I've noticed after using it for quite a while was that I wasn't quite so sure about the sonic experience in my first video. If you haven't watched it already, please go ahead and watch it because it will help you understand what this DAC is, what it does, and what about the shape. It has a very odd and unique shape. But after using it for a while, I have noticed that it has a very characteristic sound, which is extremely detailed, all while being natural. And although the detail levels are insane, it doesn't turn into a sibilance or harshness monster. Well, no, it stays very natural, slightly warm, it has a bit of added warmth, but it has a lot of punch, a very good amount of dynamics and a very transparent sound. It doesn't really color the sound in any way, and while the soundstage is quite wide, it is also very deep, and that is a very nice thing about. The headphone output also left me impressed. It just impressed me. The headphone output just felt like an extra, and it still feels because the DAC is so well made. It just doesn't really look like the type of DAC / headphone amplifier you use on your desk. Usually you place it on your desk, like below your monitor or right next to it, but this is too long, too tall to place it there. So it doesn't look like it was made to be used with headphones, but it sounds so good with headphones. I want to use it with headphones. I just can't stop myself from using it. I just am enjoying the sound of its headphone output. It really blew me away in terms of dynamics. The sound of the headphone output is just so dynamic. It is not the type of sound that I would recommend if you wanted the deepest sound out there, because with headphones you really need to have a very low Z or low impedance headphone for it to have a lot of lows and punch in the lows. But with higher Z headphones, it tends to be a very airy kind of sound, a very wide soundstage, and a lot of instrument separation with a very good expression of detail. It is quite detailed, quite well refined, and actually was surprised because I am coming from pretty expensive DACs, amplifiers, and even headphones. I have a lot of high-end stuff. But this one, every single time I plug a headphone inside it, it feels like, wow, this is real. This is dynamic. This is wow. This is like a very clean window to my music. And I'm just having this experience every single time I plug it in. It is not my honeymoon with it. It is not a period I am impressed with it because it is new to me. It is just the way it impresses you every single time you open it up. And that is a nice thing. It is so nice to have something that will surprise you every single time you hear it. I have noticed another thing that when you are using it with something like a speaker setup, because I've been trying it with my speakers, I have a few pairs actually, quite a few, and I have a pretty high-end amplifier for the speakers, the Jadis Orchestra Reference, which is pretty good, not quite that new, but pretty excellent. Well, with that amplifier, I've noticed something, one important thing. You need to have decent cables between the DAC and the amp. If you don't have decent cables, it is going to sound quite poorly because it is so revealing and it has so much detail. If you are using very cheap, very entry-level cables, like $5 of a cable, you are going to cut a lot of its resolution out. Well, when I upgraded the setup to a pretty mediocre cable, I'm not talking about expensive cables here, just get yourself a decent cable, just something that is decent. Everything improved, everything just magically become magic. The sound opened up, the soundstage became wider, the detail just flew. Well, that is the thing. And I'm not even using expensive cables. At this point, I'm using cables that cost about $100 for both cables, for both left and right. So I'm talking here about $100 or $50 per cable, which is pretty good of a price for audiophiles. And considering the price point of the analog audio AA DAC, you aren't going to cry if you invest just a tiny bit in the cable. But just do it. Do it for yourself. Do it for enjoying it at the maximum. Analog audio AA DAC gives me the impression that it was made for speaker users. And if you are a speaker user and if you are considering the analog audio AA DAC, I also recommend considering considering getting the amplifier made by Analog Audio and other components made by them, because the unique shape and ergonomic it has actually makes it much better to use them together, because you have a much better looking setup, cleaner looking setup, and everything just works better that way. It looks pretty good standalone, but when paired with its bigger brothers, it looks even better. As a DAC/ headphone amplifier, if you have just the standalone DAC unit, it is going to be a pretty odd one out. Most devices tend to be much wider, much shorter, and much thinner, actually. Most of my DACs are much thinner, considerably thinner. Well, this one is a thick boy, a long boy, and a pretty narrow boy at the same time. It has this unique shape and I actually like it. As you can see, it has enough space to cool off, but it doesn't really get that hot. It doesn't really consume that much power. It is a DAC, it is not an amplifier. The amplifier unit tends to consume the most power from your system. If you are curious about that, the DAC unit tends to consume very little power usually, especially if you leave it in idle or if you have it closed. It doesn't really draw that much power, but the power delivery inside is of an excellent quality, and I need to tell you this. With the Analog Audio AA DAC, I noticed the least improvement when getting better power cords and getting better power conditioners. They tend to not make much of a difference, and I actually experimented a lot with it before coming to this conclusion. I just needed a lot of time to understand what a power conditioner does, because at first I thought they do quite a lot. But after listening to it, after giving it time to burn in, and this is pretty important, after leaving it running for a few hours, I just noticed that having a power conditioner doesn't really make that much of a difference. An ABX test was not possible, and I'll be honest with you, I don't have two of those to connect one with a power conditioner and one without one. So I tried my best to equalize the volume between the two tests, and I tried to take notes between them. I even tried to blindfold myself while taking the test, but no ABX was possible, to be honest. And I don't know if anyone will be able to do an ABX test, but after really testing it and after volume matching, I think that the Analog Audio power delivery, the heavy part in this, because it is so heavy, because of that the case is actually pretty light, but yeah, the power delivery, you can actually feel the place where it is heaviest. Well, that power delivery is crazy. It is so awesome. It has such a clean power that you just don't need to upgrade it. So if you don't need to upgrade it, I recommend investing the leftover money in speakers. Invest it in something that makes even more of a difference. Don't invest it in optimizing it. It is optimized. It is optimized to sound best without any more spending. You don't really need to spend more money to enjoy the Analog Audio AA DAC. You can enjoy it out of the box. The feet are also made of rubber and they are quite tall, so you have quite a bit of space beneath it. But as I said, it is pretty cool running already. You won't need to cool it down. You won't need to be concerned about it. At the back, you have two options for connecting the amplifier of your speakers or of your headphones. You have either RCA or XLR connectors. Those two are the two options. I do not recommend having two amplifiers, one connected to the RCA and one connected to the XLR. It is going to add quite a bit of distortion and it is not a recommended use scenario. So I kindly advise you to avoid that. Also, it is recommended to not leave a headphone connected and have the cables at the back connected to a speaker if you are listening to both at the same time, because it is going to downgrade the signal quite a bit. I recommend having either just speakers connected or just headphones connected. Just use only one output for the best sonic experience. The 2.4 GHz antenna actually enables you to enjoy it wireless. And well, the quality is quite excellent. The quality is not quite so excellent as is the convenience of it. I just mean it. You have this awesome speaker setup, you have a friend coming over and you want to show him a song. So what do? You go searching for your favorite CD, you put it in your CD player / transport, you hit play, you turn your entire system. Well, if you have the Analog Audio AA DAC, you can do all of those from your smartphone. You can set everything up, you can just press play. It is much more convenient, and I'll be honest with you, I enjoyed that about the number of inputs. Also include two coaxial inputs, an ASB/EBU input, an optical input, and a USB input, which is of a very good quality. This is one of those DACs where you don't really need a better USB cable to enjoy it. It is one of those DACs where you just can enjoy it out of the box. It comes with a pretty good USB cable. Everything it comes with is pretty good already. So you don't really need anything else to enjoy it, to make it yours, to be happy that you went with the Analog Audio AA DAC. Before ending this review, I wanted to mention, and it is a very special mention, about the competitors of the Analog Audio AA DAC. And the most direct competitor I've reviewed is the DAC One Special from SW1X audio from UK. Well, the difference between them is actually quite obvious when you listen to both side by side, because that is actually quite easier. And the analog audio DAC is wider, considerably wider. It is deeper in soundstage. It has more instrument separation and more detail. The SW1X tends to be a tiny bit more dynamic, but at the same time, it tends to have a much more narrow USA scenario, because with the SW1X DAC 1 Special, you just have the SPDIF input, and that pretty much limits your entire USA scenario. Well, with the analog audio DAC, you don't have to worry. You can have optical, USB, coaxial. You can have pretty much everything you want from it. It's just a multimedia center already. It is not that much of an audiophile DAC, as much of a convenient solution for enjoying your music collection, for enjoying movies, because you can connect it to a movie player or a DVD player. It is just convenient to have it, and yeah, I truly recommend this. Before ending this review, I will tell you, it's on beautiful, but I will also recommend, test it. If you can, just test it, give it a try, and let us know what you thought. Let us know how it sounded for you. Let us know if you loved it, and why did you like it so much, if you enjoyed it. I thank you for watching this video. I hope you'll consider pressing like on this video. Also, press subscribe, because if you enjoyed it, I hope you will be watching my other videos too. I thank you for watching once again, and hope you have a lovely week in there. Bye bye.